This video is going to be looking at the install and fitment of DEVOL radiator guards on a 2006 Suzuki DR-Z400s. The Suzuki radiator guards are a series of plastic louvered fins. I wanted a little more protection as well as some support in the very likely event that I dumped the bike on its side. The DEVOL radiator guards showed up like this. The package contained the right and left guards, two new lower cover bolts, spacers, and instructions. The cut and bend quality is excellent and the welds look fine. The instructions are short and simple. The first step is to remove the three bolts holding each of the plastic radiator side covers on. The bolts have 8mm heads on them. After the radiator covers are off, you need to remove the plastic louvered fins. Push on the side pins while bending the outermost fin to pop the mounting pins out. Once the outer pins are disengaged, the whole assembly comes right out. If you need to, this is a good time to take a brush and clean out any junk that might be in the radiator fins. Next, remove the mounting bolts that hold the radiator to the frame. These bolts have 10mm heads on them. Here's something to look out for. Take your radiator mounting bolts and drop them into the DEVOL guard's mounting holes. The captured washers on my radiator mounting bolts were too wide to seat flush against the guard's mounting tabs. To fix that issue, I simply took the washer to the grinder for a quick clearancing pass. By shaving off a flat spot, the washer would now seat flush against the mounting tab. In my opinion, it's always a good idea to put some kind of medium thread locker on external bolts involved in a motorcycle. I really like this VC3 from Vibratite. You pre-apply it to the bolts and let it dry before installing. VC3 is actually reusable, allowing you to install, remove, and install again without needing to reapply. I'm not sponsored by Vibratite in any way, I've just had really good results with this product. DEVOL provides a longer lower cover mounting bolt and a spacer. Make sure you move the shouldered washer from the factory bolt over to the longer DEVOL bolt. That washer is there to keep the bolt head from biting into the plastic radiator cover when you tighten it down. Drop the radiator mounting bolts into the DEVOL guard mounting tabs. Hold the guard up and get the bolt started through the rubber radiator mounts and into the frame. Once you have the guard where you want it, run the frame bolts into 10 Nm or 7 foot-pounds. If you're going to work on your bike a lot, it's probably a good idea to invest in a torque wrench that reads in the lower newton meter values. Years ago, I bought one for working on carbon bicycle components, and it works great on these small motorcycle bolts. Once the radiator and guard are bolted to the frame, take the included spacer and install the new longer bolt with the original shouldered washer, but don't tighten it yet. Get the cover to fit over the upper mounting bosses in the gas tank, and then install the other two original cover mounting bolts and washers. Once all the bolts are in, tighten the three cover mounting bolts to 6 newton meters or 4.5 foot-pounds. Just snugging them in there will be fine. These are small bolts, just let the thread locker do its job. There's no need to really crank them in there. Once you've got both sides on, check your front fender clearance by turning the bars left to right a couple times. I didn't have any issues, but if you did, remember you've got some up and down adjustment in the slotted DEVOL mounting tabs. Well, that's it. Pretty easy install for just about any skill level. Now you can go ride hard with a little more peace of mind. Thanks for watching my video. If you liked it or found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up vote, subscribe to my channel, or if you're so inclined, share the video on social media or your favorite motorcycle forum. All those things help me to keep making more of these videos. Thanks!